before we get going, if you could like, comment, share, feel the love, and press some of these buttons up here, I believe, or here, with regards to this video, that would be great. So this week on Legal Tech 101, we are speaking to Susan Hackett, who is the CEO and founder of Law Execs, and we are talking, for the first time in 10 episodes, technology. Hallelujah. We talk about technology and how legal departments are implementing it, what they do with their technology of the past, and how to future-proof themselves in years 2, 3, and 4. Enjoy.
And now for something completely different.
But for the benefit of people who don't know who you are, could you just give us a bit of an introduction?
Sure. Well, I'm Susan Hackett. As you said, I'm the CEO of a consultancy called Legal Executive Leadership. It's a consultancy that works with law departments and also to a large extent with the people who support them. So people who are in law firms or other kinds of law companies that work in that, in their sphere, if you will. And I work on management side practices. I'm focused on helping law departments rethink the way they do their work to improve their efficiency or to target better results or to look at what it is they should prioritize and how they can move to next law or new law kinds of practices for the future.
And so what I really wanted us to talk to about today is about legal departments. On this podcast, we talk a lot about lots of different things. It's not always tech. But today I was very keen to kind of get your thoughts on how us as, I suppose, external providers can better support legal departments, where you see legal departments now and how they can best think about themselves going into the future, if that works.
Yeah, well, and I'm really thrilled to talk about this because, you know, I was having conversations just recently with some friends, and the guy I was talking to about this, Jason Barnwell, who's at Microsoft, and he's just a brilliant lawyer on this stuff, he raised this point that what's going on in law departments and the whole change movement in the legal profession generally, that's aided and supported by legal technology and data practices that flow from them, is really part of a longer continuum. And so a lot of people complain about, you know, are law departments and law firms doing enough yet to move the needle, to start thinking about new ways to work, to deploy technology and data and their practices more effectively and so on. And they're all frustrated that we aren't moving faster. And his concept is, and I think it makes some sense, that if you're looking at the continuum, it takes time for any kind of new thing to adapt, especially in a profession like law, which is really not known for being, you know, they're risk averse, if you will. The lawyer community tends to be risk averse. They tend to be very focused on looking back at precedent and looking back at how we've always done it, and the ideas of changing or innovating or moving to new kinds of practices really kind of freak them out, as well as threaten them. But now I think you're really starting to see people picking up on these kinds of practices, and particularly in an area that I know you're very interested in and on it, and that you've been a leader in developing, which is this idea of bringing workflow and systems and platforms that can actually become the baseline of what it is that a law department and all of its partners in law firms and law companies and in the company itself, you know, so that when you're working with people within the organization, everybody can be on this system and working collaboratively to start rethinking the way they do their work and doing it more effectively.
It makes sense. It's the terminology people quite often use is like enterprise level solutions, right? So Microsoft is an enterprise level solution.
Right.
But I think we've had to go through process, as you said, to get here. And I think technology has also done a bit of a disservice to the legal departments as well by going, look at all of this stuff you can do, but PS, the GC still having his emails printed off. And for someone to go from 0 to 1 million miles an hour and have a platform to all these bells and whistles and things like that, it's just not a scalable model. So how have you seen this evolve? Is it because the new generation have come in and like our iPhones, for example, do everything, so it's just that transition? Or do you think it's people are just becoming more savvy with regards to technology?
Well, I think on the law department side, there's a slightly different factor. I think, for, you know, thinking about lawyers being further behind where corporates were generally, not corporate in-house legal departments, but just companies in general, in adopting technology. You know, law firms run their own businesses. So they can make their own decisions about what they want to adopt and how they want to adopt it. And they hire their own tech people and they've got their own experts and they can choose what they wish to do and what they don't wish to do. When you're in a corporate legal department, you are a business function and more importantly, an expense center. Mm-hmm. Within a larger organization, you don't necessarily have the same kind of autonomy to run your practice the way you want, like a law firm was. A law department has an additional pressure, which is that they're working within an organization with expectations. So if they are using enterprise level systems like a Salesforce, or they're using through a Microsoft platform, things that are SharePoint based services or whatever it might be, there's an expectation that law departments will be able to speak that language, even if they don't use that particular system, which quite honestly, especially in a lot of companies with smaller law departments, they look at legal departments who come in and say, I want to choose legal technology. And they're looking at the department saying, no, you're going to plug in to what it is that every other damn function in this company uses and you know, toe the line with everybody else to, this is how we speak and communicate. This is how we share and collaborate. This is where the numbers are. This is where the strategies take place. This is where people work. You know, you don't get to live on your own private island.
Mm. So how do you guys help in that environment? So say, for example, I'm a legal department.
Right.
Again, I've got external or internal pressures to toe the line. So use SharePoint, use Word, use email.
Right.
How do you guys go into that environment and go, okay, Mr. and Mrs. Lawyers, we're going to help you. Right. And this is right. what our recommendation is. How do you guys do that?
Well, I'm a big believer that a lot of people need to understand that technology is not the end. It's the tool to do what it is that you prioritize in your work. And so I tend not to be the person who comes to implement a technology, but to sit down and start a strategy kind of a conversation with a legal department about identifying the work that it really should be focusing its time and attention to doing, as well as what kinds of supports are out there to get that work done and how a team within the department or teams that include people who are outside of the department may best get that work done. So, you know, I the way I usually phrase it with people is I help them do the right work, the right way with the right people, the right resources, at the right cost to get the right result, right? So I'm the person who comes in to look at what the options are. And I don't tend to go into a department, therefore, and say, here's what it is you should be doing, and here's the technology that'll do it for you, and let me help you get that started. Mm-hmm. I tend to come in and talk with people about what work they're doing, what work they're not getting to, the gaps, if you will, what kinds of work they really should be thinking about automating and eliminating or moving. And once you've started to get some answers, or at least some clarity and a direction around that, then you start to talk about what kinds of technology and data and other kinds of resources would support that function. To use another analogy on this, when law departments start talking about going out and rethinking their law firm relationships, and we're going to do a big convergence process and we'll get an RFP going and everything. And I usually say to people, have you ever sat down and talked with procurement in your company about this?
Yeah.
And lawyers look at me, oh, procurement, what would procurement know about hiring law firms? And you kind of go, okay.
You just need to go and have a talk.
We have some things to talk about here. You know, it's the same kind of thing. They see this thing that other people are doing, and they decide it would be a great thing to have better control over contracts because they're the lifeblood in our organization, but they haven't done the requisite work. They want to jump. I think that's a lot of the difficulty right now in the market, is that lack of a strategy of the self-awareness in the department of what they should be working on before they start going out and buying stuff to do. So I'm a big fan of buying stuff, mm-hmm. but you don't make a good decision unless you know what's going to work well and what you want your team to do.
I think that's a perfect place to leave it. So Susan, thank you so much for your time. Really appreciate it.
Always wonderful to talk with you. I hope we'll have a chance to talk again soon.